Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Chaithra. We get quite a lot of patients who's been married for different varied number of years. They would have tried n number of natural conception with the help of ovulation induction drugs or the IUI. So what is the limit that you should take into consideration before going to n number of cycles? For ovulation induction and natural timed intercourse, that means we are going to give tablets for your follicle to grow. Then once it attains a good size, then we are going to give the injection for it to get released. We are going to tell you those are the times that you have to be together for increasing the conception rate. That is the OITI cycle. This maximum we try for 12 cycles over the number of whatever married life, even if you have taken in between gaps. So overall, when we take it as 12 cycles, that's the maximum. 97% of the people who has the capability to conceive naturally will conceive within this. After that, there is no point in continuing this forever. So what is the next thing that we try is IUI, that is intrauterine insemination. What do we do in this? Again, we are going to give the tablet for the follicle to grow. Once it attains a good size, we are going to give the injection for it to get released. In this time, what we are going to do, we are going to take the semen sample from your husband, we're going to process it, take only the best sperms which has good motility, morphology. We are going to select those things and put it inside your uterus. So this is IUI. So what is the thing? Here maximum around 6 cycles we can try. Again, after this we can try how many ever cycles it is, but success chances are going to be less. So there is no point in continuing doing n number of IUI cycles after this. So say after 2 or 3 cycles of IUI, if I have not conceived, then get your tubes checked, the fallopian tubes. That is the bridge between egg and sperm. So that should be patent, that should be open. Then only the egg and sperm is going to meet, and then fertilization happens and implantation happens. So if that is blocked, again there is no point in continuing. Then we have to go for IVF directly. So in assisted reproduction, mainly one is naturally we ask them to try by giving a small oral medication. Other than that, it's IUI and IVF. So in IUI, what we do, again we are going to see when you are going to ovulate. We are either going to give an ovulation induction drugs and give the injection for the trigger for it to get released, so that we can time that IUI. IUI is processing husband sample and getting this best sperms out of it and putting it inside the uterus during the in and around the timings of ovulation. So this increases the chances of sperm and egg being together at the certain moment. But inside what is happening, whether sperm is going and meeting the egg or not, we have no idea. So this is a basic level. This is just an upgraded natural process. So it will only cost you drugs and IUI process charges. Intend to grow all the follicles that we see in the scan. So you need a daily hormonal injections. Yes, those injections are costly. And we are going to do the oocyte pickup under anesthesia. Again, anesthesia charges. We are going to do the fertilization in the lab, then grow the embryo, freeze it. So all these process and what are the media we use, the techniques that they use inside the lab, everything will amount to that cost. That's why IVF is a costly process. We cannot do it in a less money, because hormonal injections, beat or lab procedures or any other things, everything is costly. That's why it is costlier compared to other treatments.